Hello, and welcome to Chapter 2 of the General Chemistry Lecture. So, in Chapter 1, we kind of looked at some of the fundamental ideas of science, like making measurements and significant figures and dimensional analysis and things like this. But in Chapter 2, we're actually going to get into the chemistry, the beginnings of chemistry, and we're going to talk about atoms, molecules, and ions. We will start that with some early ideas about atomic theory. We'll talk about some of the major experiments that went into determining our understanding of the structure of an atom. We'll look at the atomic structure and the symbols for the subatomic particles, protons, neutrons, and electrons, and where they are in an atom that came out of the evolution of atomic theory. Then we'll start to look at some chemical formulas, the periodic table, which is a quite remarkable arrangement of the atoms in a very logical order. And then finally, we'll look at actually identifying, naming, and even finding the formulas of some molecular and ionic compounds and the chemical nomenclature that goes with that. So this chapter has quite a lot of information. As an introduction, this first slide is showing us the analysis of exhaled breath. And you can see that here the person is breathing out carbon dioxide, nitrogen from the atmosphere, and then some other compounds. And we'll talk about some of these compounds. Not specifically for the exhale of a breath, but we will talk about, you know, how to understand what these formulas mean and how to draw the formulas of certain compounds and things like this. Later on in the course, we'll get to things like carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Here, in this chapter, we're going to stick to mostly ionic compounds, other than naming, where you'll be given the formula. And in ionic compounds, we're going to have a metal and a nonmetal. So that's essentially where we're going in Chapter 2.